either side they pick, throwing it, running it, it won't be easy.
So backed up to the six now, third and goal. Now it's Ryan. Can't hang on to it. Almost intercepted. They would have loved the first pick of the game there, but at least it does get them to fourth down.
I guess they're in a situation now, fourth quarter, where they're forced to take some chances, but I don't know that that was the type of a chance you want to take.
And that one could very easily have been intercepted. And if it does get picked off, that could possibly seal this one.
And the 42-year-old veteran's kick is up and good. And in the fourth quarter, this game is tied. I tell you, the life of a kicker. He has not been called on the entire game. He's over there by the net, but they send him out here in the fourth quarter and say, hey, go tie the game, will you? And guess what? He comes through.
I just don't know how they do it. I really don't. These cats are a different breed from you and me. That's a pressure kick, but that one was never in doubt.
This fielded at the two. Return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. And after the field goal last time, we'll see what they can get here. At least they got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I've never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them wanted to end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it. Way better than the alternative, which is a punt.
Yeah, but you met fan bases that wanted that. They were happy with that field goal.
I haven't met a fan base yet that wants a drive to end with a kick, other than the extra point. That's it.
It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets them to second and four.
Let's talk a little football 101 here, because one of the keys to advancing the ball downfield, success on first down. Huge difference, as we know, between second and four and second and eight and nine.
Second down following the run. Here comes the D swarming to the line. On second down, it's Bell. They get five out of that one, and it moves the chains.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. That's almost a tendency breaker.
And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground. They go play action here on first down. On the left side, it's McDonald. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. A gain of 10, good for a Steeler first down. So here we go, first and 10 now. They'll run it now, out of the gun. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling.
Absolutely love the run right there. This guy's known for his quickness, but also for his speed, and he's able to get to the second level almost before you blink if you give him any type of blocking. Always talk about slot receivers, and they're usually known as quicker than fast. In this case, we've got a guy who's quick and fast, and he used it to great advantage.
Tie game late, and the offense really has to be conscious of the clock here as it's becoming a factor late in this ball game. They'll go again with Bell, and he'll get about three as he's brought down to the 28.
Not much happening there on first down.
I thought there might have been a hole for a split second.
Yeah, but it dried up pretty quickly, didn't it? Closed fast.
tie game here. Time starting to run down. The defense really needs to try and keep this game tied, see if they can get the ball back to the offense. Now Roethlisberger to throw. Throw left side complete. That's McDonald. And he's able to get it to the edge of the red zone at the 20-yard line. They get 9 out of that one, and as a result, the drive continues. Time for a break. We'll come back and see how it all shakes out after this. They'll run it now out of the gun. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's 2nd and 4.
I like it. I like the call. Still an opportunity to run the football and chew up a little more time off the clock.
See if they stay on the ground for 2nd down. Shift together here from the D-line. Throwing now is Roethlisberger. That is caught at the 7-yard line. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. Now a 2nd timeout called for by the defense. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the 1st down. And the offense in a great spot. It's 1st and goal from the 3. Defense showing blitz.
Here we go.
They'll try and run it in with Bell. And he's maybe going to get this back to the 4, but that's about all. No gain on the play that time, and it sets up 2nd and goal. They come out here in the eye.
All right, here we go.
Ball spotted at the 4. It's 2nd and goal. Here's Bell. That is not going to be any help as they dump him behind the line of scrimmage. They'll wind up losing 3 yards here. And that's going to bring up an interesting 3rd and goal. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. That'll be their 3rd and final stoppage here as we step aside. And the offense readies for play number 10 of this series. Here's Bell. And he'll take this one down inside the 5 to the 3. It's about a 3-yard pickup there, but more importantly, they're still a few yards away here. It's now 4th down and goal. Now they get the timeout. It leads you to wonder, will they kick it here or risk running another play and possibly not getting down in time? We'll see. So on now for the field goal try, Chris Boswell. He made his only attempt earlier. This for the win. So there was a little meat on that bone, a little more than a chip shot considering the circumstances, but he's able to bang it home in what should.